Now, for 2P, we'll see what happens when we have to fill in 2P, when we go lower down. But before we do that, we've been talking about the electron configuration. How am I supposed to know what the electron configuration of an element is? The way we're able to do this is basically in two ways, depending on what your professor feels like teaching you. One way, we're going to look at the periodic table in a very different light. We're accustomed to seeing the periodic table with its elements and its atomic numbers and its atomic masses. In this image, we basically break down the periodic table in this way. We're going to look at it in this fashion in order to write the electron configuration of the element. And just realize that the periodic table is separated into different sections. We're going to say group 1A and 2A are what we call the S block. Helium, which is over here, would be part of that. Okay, so it'd be grouped in together with it. And remember, how many electrons can the S hold? S can hold 2 electrons. And if we're talking about the S block, we're talking about 2 groups, group 1 and group 2. Each group has a total of 1 electron it can hold. Down here in the pit, we call this our D block. And remember, how many electrons can the D orbital hold? It can hold up to 10. And look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here, 3A to 8A, excluding helium, they're called the P block. See, these are our P block elements. And how many electrons can the P hold? P orbital can hold up to 6 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then finally, down here with the lanthanides and the actinides, these are our F block. F can hold up to 14. So if you count this, you'll get 14 total. So the periodic table basically is arranged in a way where this makes sense. Also, what you should realize here is that the periods, remember this is period 1, period 2, all the way to period 7. The period number reflects the shell number. Okay, so we have 7 periods as of now. So we have 7 shells as of now for our biggest elements. And we're going to say here that the period number basically tells me the number of the orbital. So in period 2, we have 2s and 2p. In period 3, we have 3s, we also have 3d, and we have 3p. For 4, period 4, we have 4s, 4d, 4p, and 4f. If you add those up, that tells you the total number of electrons within shell 3, shell 4. What you should also realize here from this trend is when we go from 4s, we drop down one when we go to the D block. So it dropped down to 3D.